Before we get this video started, I just want to say thank you to our patrons.
Yes, because you guys are awesome, and thank you so much for your support.
All right, let's get the video started. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to One Strange Adventure. Welcome to the next video. Today we're coming to you from Soo Locks.
Yes, which is in Sault St Marie up in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan.
Yep, that body of water behind us is where the big ships come. Yep. And they flood them up, or flood the locks up so they can go. So it's like a step up or a step down, depending on what direction they're going, from between Lake Superior and Lake Huron.
So this week we had met with Lori and Corey from the Northwoods RV, and she gave us a list of things that she loves to do while she's up here. So we're going to be checking some of the things off.
Lots
of that
stuff
list
to do up here. And yeah, this town is actually, there's a lot of things here. Like, we went and had B-dubs tonight
already,
for dinner.
Yeah.
And it's a travel day. So we just got here. We came from the KOA down in St. Ignace, which was a really nice stop.
Yep. Now we're up here for 2 weeks, and hopefully we get to do like a boat tour. I would love to do that. And then are going to go hunt down some Upper rocks.
Oh yeah.
Some Upper lights.
That's pretty cool if you've ever seen them. But we are excited to be back in the UP up on Lake Superior. We love it up here. And if you've never been up here, highly recommend taking a trip into the UP. You may not know, but it's like the wilderness. Most of it is like wilderness.
Yes.
It's like intro to Alaska.
And if you don't have AT&T or T-Mobile, there is almost no service when you go on hikes.
Yep.
Or in the route to the hikes, because you're driving through wilderness.
Yep. Starlink's doing good. T-Mobile's doing great. AT&T's okay. Verizon, meh. We are excited to get this show started and go explore. This campground's pretty nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a very small, quaint campground.
Yep.
Doesn't have a pool.
$35 a night.
$35 a night. We don't have full hookup. We just have 30 amp electric and water.
Yep.
So they do have two dump stations on your way out.
We stayed, when we first came into the UP, we stayed down south at St. Ignace KOA and did the Mackinac Island thing and St. Ignace and the helicopter that you've already seen at this point.
Which is awesome.
Amazing. And then we came straight up 75 to Sault St. Marie.
Yes. So this place has a little bit of everything that you need. They have a Walmart and a couple of different restaurants.
Yeah, there's a lot more stores here.
There's a PetSmart up here, or not PetSmart, but a PetSense store up here.
Yep.
Pet friendly stores. There is a Buffalo Wild Wings, if you like that.
There's just a lot more up here than there is in St. Ignace. St. Ignace is more like the local stuff, and then up here is more like you have the big box brands.
Yes. Now, we are taking the Soo Locks boat tour tomorrow.
Yep, which is Friday. And then Saturday, we're going out to Whitefish Point.
Yes, and hopefully...
And waterfalls.
Hopefully see some
I waterfalls. Cannot pronounce the waterfalls. Just read it down here.
Go see the waterfalls. Hopefully to see two different lighthouses. And hopefully we can find some Upper lights.
Yes, if you haven't done that before, that is so cool. You go out at dark with a black light on the shore of Lake Superior, and you find the rocks that glow, and it's really cool when they do.
Yes. So hopefully we can find some. If not, we'll take videos of the ones that are in the office.
Yep.
Because they have some up there.
Come on, vamanos. It is Friday, and we are at the Soo Locks boat tour, just like we said. So it was $80 for four of us to do this.
Well, kids were cheaper.
And our tour time, it's like every 2 hours, two, four. I think 4 o'clock's the last one, but noon to 4 o'clock. And we're at the 4 o'clock one because we both had to work. So we're going to go see what this is all about. I think we go into the locks and do all that cool stuff.
That's what I paid for, so.
Hopefully.
I hope that's what we do.
We'll find out. We'll let you guys know. Look at them. Look how tall he's getting. We just left the gift shop, where the area where you get your tickets. There's this long path you just kind of walk down and you sit and wait for your boat. You board 15 minutes ahead of time. So I don't know, maybe get here 20, 30 minutes a little ahead of time, and you can come down and sit and wait for your ride. Lots of history around these parties.
There is a lot of history.
Like 1850? 1881. 1881 is when they built the first lock.
No.
That's what he said, the locks?
No, I don't know the exact date. I was saying no, 1881 was the church.
Oh, well, it was the 1800s when they built the lock.
Yeah, it was 1800s. I don't remember the exact date.
I think we're getting ready to go into a lock, so.
We're circling. We're just waiting for
another boat.
For the lock to be ready.
It takes like 22 million gallons to fill it up. For the boats to rise to the top of the next one. 22 million gallons of water. It's insane. I guess we're going to experience that. So the water on that side of the fence is 21 feet higher than it is on this side of the fence. We're gonna pump all that water, it's all gravity fed, goes up down underneath the gate, comes up the pipes inside here, raising us up, and then we're gonna go out that gate. Then it's gonna be the reverse when we come back. So we'll come down 21 feet to leave. It's kinda cool.
How cool is that?
So what'd you think?
I thought it was pretty awesome.
Yeah?
I think my favorite part is this railroad track though. That's like amazing.
Half of the bridge like opens up from the middle and then the other half just raises straight up.
One piece goes up like this and the other two arms open like scissors.
So now we've been lowered back down another 21 feet. From Lake Superior level to Lake Huron level. And the gates are opening. We're getting ready to go back through. It takes about 20 minutes. Actually, it took a little faster. It was a little faster to drain it, but it took about 20 minutes to fill it up, which was pretty awesome. What'd you think of that?
I thought it was pretty cool.
That was fun.
My favorite part, like I was saying earlier on the boat, is the railroad train tracks, that bridge that moves.
Yeah.
Because, I mean,
it's really pretty.
Who would have thought?
Right?
It's so that the big container ships can come through and the railroad track can still be in operation. And they said it operates 2 to 3 times a day.
I mean, I just love watching water go up and down. The boat go up and down.
I know, you're fascinated with that because it fills from the bottom and drains it.
It's all gravity. There's no pumps.
Nope.
So that's really cool. Modern, like engineer. Well, not even modern.
No.
It's an engineer feat from a long time ago.
It took so many people's great minds to come up with that type of concept. And then like this big, huge building that we didn't know what it was, it's actually a
power plant
or electricity plant like Clear Lake Dam is, where it's got the big turbines underneath this building.
Mm-hmm.
And so it sucks in the water and the water change difference is, I think she said like 14 inches. 14 feet from one side to the other.
Yep.
And so it creates energy for this whole area. And that building is a quarter of a mile long.
It's a big building.
It's so big.
If you're in Sault Ste. Marie and you're in this area of the UP, you recommend?
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
Yeah. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's about 2 hours. Plan 2 hours.
Yep.
Dogs are not allowed.
$80.
Well, $80 for the four of us.
Mm-hmm.
But dogs are not allowed, so we had to leave ours behind.
Yep. All right. Off to get dinner tomorrow, Whitefish Point. What's up, everyone? Today we are at Whitefish Point.
Yes, we're at the lighthouse and the Great Lakes Shipwreck Museum.
Yes, we're going to be touring this area. If you haven't been in Whitefish Point, it took about maybe an hour to get here.
It's about an hour and 20 minutes from our campground.
From Sault Ste. Marie.
But we decided to take the little bit longer path of going up by the lakeshore instead of the highway.
Right. It took about 10 extra minutes.
Yeah.
But it's well, it's beautiful. But yeah, we're going to be exploring this area, go out on the beach a little bit, check out Lake Superior, the lighthouse. Cindy loves lighthouses.
Try to find them all.
Try to find them all. And then the museum. I think we're actually getting ready to go in the museum.
Yep, it's $45 for a family of two adults and two or more kids, or $14 for adults and $10 for kids, 6 to 17, yep. Under 5 and under is free.
Yeah, they have some pretty famous shipwrecks in there, so... We're going to go check it out, especially the Fitzgerald.
Yeah. As, you know, there's always a theme to our adventures. We like old stuff. We like water and we like lighthouses. So this
got it all in one.
This place checks off all those boxes.
Yep. $45 for four people. And that's two adults and two youth
or
under
more.
17.
It's two or more.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay. Cool. Let's go check out the museum and then the lighthouse and then the beach. What do you think so far?
I think that lighthouse reflector is freaking amazing. I don't know what it's called.
It's pretty cool.
It's the globe
yeah.
that the light goes inside of.
It is massive. So far, we've been to the Shipwreck Museum and the Navy Radio Museum. Yeah, all of these buildings are included with your museum ticket, so you need that to get into each of these. Pretty cool. They have different ships that are dedicated. It's really cool to see this stuff, and it's also really sad.
So
many lives lost in these shipwrecks.
Yeah, I mean, you're talking about 20 to 30 people per ship.
Yeah, some more, right?
But it's really neat to see how the items have changed throughout the years too.
Right.
Improved it to make it better.
Yeah, there are so many shipwrecks on the Great Lakes. It's crazy. We're gonna look it up and see how many it actually is.
Yeah, there's a map that shows you like all of them, but it doesn't say an exact number, so we'll have to see.
Yeah, there's a massive amount of shipwrecks and a massive amount of lighthouses actually.
Yeah.
So let's go into this one.
Most of the shipwrecks are out in the like 17 miles offshore, so it's not even like where the lighthouses would help.
Yeah. Look at this thing. So it was connected directly to the house. It had to go up every 2.5 hours? Every 2.5 hours to the top of this thing. That's insane. That man had the biggest quads you could probably ever get.
It's a small spiral staircase that goes up the inside of the tower.
Yeah. Too bad you can't actually climb it.
Him and his wife were here from 1903 to 1931.
Yeah. Wow. He did that for that long, climbing that thing. I quit. The Theatol.
To show how they rose the bell.
Lake Superior.
It's beautiful.
That is amazing.
So this is Whitefish Point.
Yep.
Beach access. It's at the Shipwreck Museum. So when you come, parking lot's gonna be full, the road is like full.
Everybody's out here on the beach.
Everybody's out here on the beach. So the museum part is not as crowded.
Some beautiful waters.
As though. The parking lot makes you feel.
I mean, this is like, this rivals like the Keys waters.
Oh yeah. I mean, it's colder than the Keys, yeah. But it's the same color.
Yeah, but with beach and the color.
Yeah. So this part of Lake Superior actually has sand. I wonder if the sand was brought in.
Yeah, I don't know. So pretty though. If you get a chance, make it up here. Like, Lake Superior is amazing.
It's my favorite Great Lake.
I like Lake Michigan and on the north, like the northern side of it.
Yeah.
By Sleeping Bear Dunes and stuff like that. But this is beautiful too.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, if you get a chance, come up here.
Yeah, and we found out that there's islands in the lake, like the ocean. But it has like teal green waters.
Oh, it definitely looks like Caribbean.
Around the islands, but it's in the Canadian side. So
that's it for this part. But now we're heading to these waterfalls that I still cannot pronounce. And we're going to go hike them. I'm going to show you the sign in just a minute so that you can pronounce them yourself. I still can't get it.
We'll attempt it once.
Starts with the T.
Once we hear somebody else say it.
I know one of you know how to do it.
Yes.
But we're gonna go hike down to the state park.
You wanna do the upper falls or the lower falls?
It doesn't matter. Whatever falls.
I think the upper falls are bigger.
I don't know. Let's go. Alright, tell us what we're doing.
Sun's in my face.
The sun is that way. How is it in your
face?
It's
like reflecting off of that camper. we are going to see waterfalls and lighthouses.
Okay.
Up here in the UP.
Alright.
I have two on my list and I looked up online and there's like four between here and there, so.
Sweet.
I don't know if you want to hit them on the way or on the way back.
I say we do it. Just got to the falls. It is busy. It's very busy. Like, hard to find parking busy.
So the state park is considered one of the most busiest state parks in Michigan.
We stopped at the lower falls to start with. That's the first one you come to our direction.
Which is probably why it's so busy.
Yeah. So we're going to go check that out and then hopefully get some cool footage of that and then go see the upper falls.
Yes. And we were supposed to be here last Saturday, but the Shipwreck Museum took us
a lot longer than we thought.
Like 4 hours we explored. So we didn't have time to come here before the sun was setting.
Yeah, let's go check out the waterfalls. And I'm not even going to try to pronounce the waterfalls. It's T something. Hey Siri, what is, how do you pronounce these waterfalls? So we just went to the lower falls. Couple things we learned. Yes. It is way busier than I thought.
So yes, the state park is the busiest in Michigan. And for like after seeing what we saw, we know why. Everybody is hiking up the right side of the waterfalls and then you go across the 142-foot pedestrian bridge
to the island.
And then there's falls on both sides of the island. So once you're over on the island, you can get in the water.
Had no idea that you could get in the water and swim. You know, around the falls and just play and have a good day.
Yeah, I had no clue.
So if you come here,
bring bathing suits, water shoes.
Water shoes.
It is a half a mile hike from the parking lot to the
bridge
to go across. But you can go to the viewing area.
And then 4.4 miles if you want to hike. Ouch. Bring bug spray. If you want to hike from the bridge to the upper falls, it's 4.5 miles. Or you can get back in your car and drive to them.
Or they also offer shuttle services for a fee. I think it's $17 for the first person and $3 for every person in your party after that, and $1 per dog.
Cool.
If you want to do the shuttle, you can get bit by mosquitoes.
Flies.
Or bitey flies.
Yeah.
We do have a bunch of stuff in the car.
All right, let's go to the upper falls. Check that out and see what that's all about.
Okay.
Getting ready to go peek first glimpse of the Upper Falls here.
So people know him.
Yep. Back to the truck. I like the Upper Falls better.
Yeah.
They're prettier. They're bigger.
They are bigger. They said it's the biggest in Michigan.
Yeah.
But I think it means wide, not tall, because there's taller waterfalls.
Well, it's very pretty. It's Tahquamenon. It rhymes with phenomenon. Yes. That's how you remember how to say these falls.
So there's signs up here at the Upper Falls.
Yes.
With letting you know
how to
say it. Now, I will say the Upper Falls has tons of gift shops and food trucks and
the pub and brewery.
Yeah, there's a pub and brewery restaurant, which is delicious, by the way. You had a burger, I had chicken tenders.
Uh-huh. Good.
It was good. And then they have actual bathrooms, not porta potties.
Right. Yeah.
So
this one's a little bit more built up.
Yeah. I think the other one's going to be like this one
yeah.
next summer. So.
But they're both pretty. If you get a chance, come check them both out.
Yes.
I like the Upper Falls. It'd be a good place to start around like lunchtime, go see the falls, come back,
have some lunch,
and then go see the lower falls.
Mm-hmm.
Probably be a good plan. I think we're going to go find lighthouses now.
Yep.
All right.
That's the goal.
That's cool. Mm-hmm. All right. I'm sweating still from the 100 steps. When you're driving around the coastline, you're looking for lighthouses, and you find this. It's just covered in plastic. The whole lighthouse covered in plastic. They're doing something to it now. It's a beautiful lighthouse. It really is. I love the beams. Well, the metal beams, exposed beams. That's cool for architecture. And the Tyvek look. I mean, that's just. It's really nice. Come to Lake Superior and not get in Lake Superior.
Maybe not get in.
Watch this. I'm done.
I'll hold it.